لهم أنه الحق.
الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى والدين الحق ليظهر على دين كل وكفى بالله شهيدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. Jinns are just like human beings. Some of them are wicked and some of them are not wicked. Some of them are blind, some of them are not blind. Some of them are disabled, some of them are not disabled. Some of them Allah give them abilities more than the other, just like human beings. And some of them are deaf, they can't hear anything. Now, when there is a deaf jinn involved in a magic, he makes the situation very difficult. Today my main subject is discussing about a deaf jinn. Before I move forward and talk about that, let me narrate an ayah in the Quran. Allah says in the Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدْ. He created man in a very hardship. Man will always struggle unless Allah sends contentment in his heart. And then he will find peace in everywhere he move, everywhere he touch, because there's contentment. In every hardship or any turbulence, that individual will find a light and contentment. In any blessing, he'll find contentment. In any calamity, he'll find contentment. We ask Allah to give us that, because the contentment only Allah gives. Now, when there is the calamity of black magic, spiritual issues, these calamities are bad. Are very bad, because what happened when there is any shaitan there, he makes it difficult for the individual to worship Allah Rabbul Izzah. The individual will struggle in any shape or form to do the ibadah correctly. He will strive so hard sometimes and then fall short. Why? Because there is a devil there pulling the strings. And when there is a deaf devil, it makes the situation tough. You'll find an individual doing all the sorts of Islamic treatment, all the Sunnah treatment, read the Quran, praying tahajjud, all the treatment, and the situation doesn't change. He goes to the rock, he reacts a little bit here and there, and the situation is still the same. Why is that? It's because he may have a deaf jinn. Allah knows best. Allah says in the Quran, وَيَتَعَلَّمُونَ. The learned magician is the one who, when he wants to punish the individual, he sends this type of jinn to the individual. Just like a few weeks back when I said a clip about how do they do magic, they send one jinn after another. So the learned magician, when he knows this person is upright or they want to punish the person, they send this type of jinn, and Allah knows best. Is not just from any other magician. No, the high rank is the one who sends this type of jinn. And when he's there, it's tough. The individual does all the Islamic issues. Nothing works for him. Nothing works for him. There is ways to deal with the shaitan. If there's any evil shaitan who thinks he's tough, there is ways to remove him from there and to stop him from his evil stuff. Why do I say that? Allah has sent Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has showed us ways. So these ways, when they are followed, you will overcome any devil there. Because when there is a deaf devil there, the Quran will not penetrate him. He won't hear anything. He will penetrate a little bit, but it will not hit him just like in the other jinn. Few years back, I was in Coventry doing Ruqya, and I have encountered a mute jinn, dumb. He can't speak. By Allah, alhamdulillah, achieved victory on that day. Alhamdulillah. So the shaitan can be sent, any another shaitan. Whoever tells you the magician, they don't send deaf and dumb jinn, he's just joking. Because whatever I'm narrating is through experience. Few weeks back, I have met a deaf jinn. There was a doctor came here, and he had a deaf jinn. He reacts, but his reaction is very, very less. He has all the symptoms of sihr. He does everything, but nothing there. I decided to do this video by Allah Rabbul Izzah. Now, how to eliminate any jinn who thinks he's tough? Two ways, by Allah. Way number one is Allah Rabbul Izzah sends Quran for us, and the Quran has ways for us to eliminate problem like this. Why do I say this? In Surah Al-Falaq, Allah says, وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ. For those who blow. Now, the magicians, their work is blowing. They blow. And us, we need to do the same. Blow. Now, if there's that deaf jinn in your body, and you keep on reading and blowing and wiping on yourself, wallahi thumma wallahi, you will send shock waves in that body. He will flee. That's number one. Now, if you are going to have ruqya, and you know that's what your problem cannot be solved, tell the raqi or the sheikh to sit closer to you and blow on you. Every ayah, blow. Wallahi, thumma wallahi, it will be like missiles on that jinn. He will suffocate and die by Allah Rabbul Izzah. That's method number one. Method number two is you get 250 ml olive oil, 250 ml sesame oil, 250 ml of black seed oil, 250 ml of mustard oil, and get 1 spoon of cedar powder, put it inside, and get 15 to 20 drops of peppermint inside that mixture. Mix it, and get ruhob, put 1 spoon inside, mix it together, let it stay for a bit. Read Surah Al-Baqarah on it full. And in Surah Al-Baqarah, this verse says, Summun bukmun umyun, fahum la yarji'un. Summun bukmun umyun, fahum la yaqilun. Read in that mixture. Repeat on it. And then, before you have ruqya or self-ruqya, apply full from head to toe. And then go and do the ruqya. Now the ruqya you are going to do, or the qiraat you're going to read, make sure every time you read, blow on yourself. Now if you have a sheikh again, like I said before, let him read and blow on you. The blowing, believe me or not, is a fire to the devil, to the jinn. The jinn will be finishing slowly by slowly until he's extinguished. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه فإنه هو الغفور الرحيم.